What's going on, y'all? It's Nick with Bear Family Farms. I wanted to show you guys, I've had quite a different couple of folks ask me about how we keep so much netting hot for so long at all times. And there's, four major components when it comes to what we use. So we'll go ahead and start with the obvious. You're gonna have to have some kind of battery. This is a high cycling interstate battery. They use these for 18 wheelers, I believe. So pretty big battery. I'm not an electrician. I don't know much about electricity, so don't ask me about voltage and all that stuff. I know it works. This is how we run it. We have our battery. Second, we have a controller. This is a Sunlight 20 amp controller. This keeps the battery from getting overcharged from the solar energy that's coming from the solar panel, which we'll get to in a second. And then we have a Cyclops charger. It's kind of shoved in there and it's really hard to get out, but I'm gonna shoot over to a different video and I'll show you unboxing of a new charger that we just got in. We actually got two new chargers in from Cyclops. And I wanna throw out there, nobody sponsors us. Everything that we're showing you guys when it comes to fence, netting, chargers, you know, solar panel, anything that we show you guys as of right now, this is what we use and it works. And these guys aren't paying us to, you know, promote their product. We're promoting it because it works.
So in this pack, well, I just opened the box. We have some fuses. We always order extra fuses anytime we order a new charger. We keep these in the truck with us. You never know when you're gonna need a fuse because they pop sometimes. That's one of the things I like about these. Pretty easy to change fuses. But then we also ordered some quick clamps to hook onto the fence easier than what we're doing now. So with just a wire that hook straight onto the clips. But let's go ahead and get this opened up. So this is the Cyclops, I think it's the Champ. Yeah, there's that. Cyclops Champ battery powered solar fence charger. Right. So this one actually, this Brute is the one that we just saw out at the pasture that the goats are in at the moment. So, but this will probably make our, I don't know, sixth or seventh charger from them, battery powered. I'm having a little technical difficulties getting it out of the box. There we go. So, like I said, we got the Champ. It's a little bit smaller than the Brute, which we have one or two of these for big things, but as you can see, it kind of tells you everything you need to know. Two ground rod minimum. For this powered stuff, we've actually ran nettings as big as 20 to 30 rolls on this stuff, but usually when we start getting around 35 is when we'll bump up to the Brute, which is actually what we have here. This probably makes our sixth or seventh charger like this. They come with extra fuses. You actually have to, you can pull these out. I really don't like to pull them out. I'll take this piece off, and inside here is like the board and whatnot, but I'll unscrew this top portion to get these spare ones out, but I'll probably leave this one in the box just to keep it fresh, and I know that, you know, it hadn't been used yet. But we ordered another one because we're about to start some major rotations, and it's easier to have, you know, multiple chargers. You never know when one's gonna go bad. And you know, we usually keep four or five of them in use at all times. So we do have a spare. This will make a second spare and or another paddock that we can set up without having to break one down and move it. And we can just bing, bang, boom, knock them out and put up the new fence. But in here you can see little fuse. You gotta like push in. You gotta push in and twist, and then you can see the fuse, like these extra fuses that are here. And usually you can tell pretty quick if your charger's not popping. And then you got another one on this side. If your charger's not popping, that's what's gonna be your problem with these fuses. Which is why we order, always keep them in the truck, and we always order more fuses whenever we order a new charger. So yeah, that's a quick unboxing of the Champ 5 joule output battery powered bench charger. Love these chargers. I've used many chargers, Gallagher, Premier Ones. Premier One makes a good one. It's pretty small, compact. It's all in one little mechanism. We actually just set one up for the horses. But if you'd wanted electric netting, if you're wanting to set up like, you know, 20 plus nettings, this is the way to go. But if you've only setting up, you know, 5 or 10, those Premier ones are usually pretty good. It only, I think the max they go out is like maybe 2 or 3 joules. But I mean, hell, this charger, I don't remember what it ran me. I mean, we've had the same charger for going on 3 years now. Never had any issues. Just don't let them get wet. We have had one get wet, and we had to open it up in the middle and let it sit out and dry out, but it dried out pretty good. You got your negative and positive clamps that go to your battery. But this basically is what is inside all of our little white boxes. Whenever you see us unhooking and stuff, it just kind of sits in there. And it's hard to, because this is where you clamp in your wire, your negative wire here. And once it's in there, in this little hole, it's hard to, once it's in there and sitting down, it's hard to get out, which is why I didn't take it out earlier. They got these little plastic clips in the back if you wanted to mount it to something, if you built like a wood box for it or something along, which we'll probably do in the future. But right now, those plastic totes are like $8 or $9. I can put that together a lot cheaper than I can to buy some plywood or something to make a box for it. So that, with the solar panel on top of it, makes a good lid. I think this charger ran $280. The solar panel ran me another $60. So we're sitting at, what is that? Plus your battery is probably gonna run you another $90. So now, then you got your controller. If you buy a pretty good, decent controller, it's gonna run you about another $100. So $510 plus your $10 tote, $520. You're getting a very high powered charger with a lot of output energy. You're making your own. If you bought one that was pre-made like this, it's probably gonna run you about $800, $900, even $1,000. So that's why we make our own. And I say we make our own, we really don't make anything. We just buy all the materials and put it together ourselves. You know, we buy our own solar panel, we buy our own controller, buy our own battery, and we buy our own charger. And it saves us a couple $100. And when you're running 5 or 6 of these at a time, you know, that adds up really, really, really quick. This is what I recommend to everyone that's running electric netting in high quantities.
So we have the battery, the controller, the charger, and all these wires are, you know, just kind of just lengthy wires. They're just too long, so I shove them in here, keep them dry. Then the fourth component to our charging system is actually a solar panel. I believe this is maybe a 50 watt. Yeah. This is a 50 watt solar panel. It's big enough for this particular, this is the Brute from what it looks like. Yeah, the Brute. We got 10 joules of stored energy and 8 joules of output energy. And this fence here has 3 grounding rods. I think that's what it needs. Yeah, 3 grounding rod minimum. 3 grounding rods, about 4 to 8 feet apart. And then this pasture has almost 40 rolls of netting at 164 foot. So let's do the math on that. And then you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 strands of poly wire that is keeping hot. And I don't know if we have the fence charger in here or not, but we'll check that out here in a little bit and see how much voltage is putting up. So we got our negative. Positive. You can already hear it popping. And then this clip here is the one that goes to the solar panel. That's positive for that one. And there's that. You do want to keep that controller and that charger dry somehow. And we've started using, as long as the solar panels are large enough, we use them as a loop. And then it just goes on the ground. All right, so here's a little tester here. Let's see. Looks like it's getting about 6,000 kilovolts. It should be a lot hotter than that, but the ground is really dry. We do need some rain to get these grounding rods a little hot. But like I said, this is a lot of netting, a lot of wires that are staying hot by this charger. So 6,000 kilovolts is still pretty hot when you're talking about linear feet. Again, that's 164 times 40 times 8, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 strands of the polywire that goes across that keeps hot. So we'll do that math down below because I can't do that in my head.
So you'd see it twisting, breaks it loose in the ground. That's probably enough. I'll get this other one so I don't have to get back off the tractor. Trying to get a good bite on it. There we go. Oh yeah, it's going to come right out. I'm going to grab the chain and hook it on here. Just like that.